Well, hey, everybody. Today we're here with Jason from Tandem Diabetes Care, and we're going to ask him a few questions about what his journey as an engineer and what it's like to be an engineer. And I would think Jason might be particularly interesting to you to hear from because he is a Biola alum. So at any rate, Jason, welcome to the class. And let me start by asking you to kind of describe the journey. How did you decide to become an engineer?
Yeah. Hi. So my name is Jason, Jason Guzan. Let's see. So I guess I would start from enrolling or applying to Biola. I did apply as a computer science major. Honestly, at the time, I wasn't sure what I wanted to pursue. So I kind of just chose a major that sounded interesting. I figured if I didn't like it, I could switch eventually. But stuck with it, graduated class of 2014 with that computer science degree. And then even at that point, I was still unsure as to, you know, okay, computer science is pretty flexible. There are many fields that I could have went into. So I really didn't know what I wanted to do with my degree. So what happened was, my parents ended up meeting Tom, and that seemed like a good opportunity. At first, medical device industry sounded really intimidating, but then that's how I ended up there, and I ended up loving how we do things at Tandem, and that's how I became a software engineer.
All right. Okay. So you just said something I'm really interested in. You said that medical device sounded really intimidating. And the thing I haven't told the class yet is that, we, the senior managers, we often get together and we kind of talk about the engineers in the organization and, you know, where people line up. And of all the young engineers, Jason's absolutely number one in our organization. So I would have thought you're the last person that would have been, feeling intimidated. You're doing very well at Tandem. So tell me a little bit about that. How did that intimidation look? Did you come to realize it wasn't warranted? I mean, kind of talk me through that.
Yeah, I think with the pressure of working on a device that could harm someone's life, because an insulin pump, you know, if something goes wrong and it delivers too much insulin or even too little, where we're reporting inaccurate data or something like that, the thought of that, okay, my code could potentially harm someone, was very intimidating. But of course, once I started learning about how we thoroughly test everything, how we document everything, how closely FDA looks at our software and things like that, it was a comfort to know that, okay, you know, it's beyond just my code. If anything goes wrong, we're going to find it well beforehand, well before it actually gets into a customer's hand. So I think that was part of it, of how I learned to deal with that intimidation. As well as I kind of found that my personal style and approach to engineering, I'm a little bit more detail oriented, I guess you could say. And I found that actually worked well with how we do our process here at Tandem. So I think that worked out.
Oh yeah, boy, you're a very detail oriented and that's one of the many things we like. Hey, so what was that like then coming to Tandem as a new grad? Sometimes I meet new grads who feel like, I got a degree in computer science, I'm going to come help you. And other times I'll meet ones who are more like, I am not sure I'm even qualified to do this, even though I have a degree in computer science. You know, so there's sort of, on the one hand, unwarranted insecurity, and on the other hand, unwarranted overconfidence. Where were you on that, and can you tell us anything about that journey?
Yeah, I definitely fell on the side where with much less confidence. I like I said, at going into college, I wasn't really sure that I wanted to pursue computer science specifically. Mm-hmm. And as I took the classes, I found it interesting, but I still wasn't 100% sure on how all of these concepts that I was learning actually added up into like a real project. So I think starting to work at to actually start working with a real product was where I really started learning, okay, so this thing that I learned in a class like 3 years ago, this is why it's useful. Uh-huh. And I learned so much more actually working than I actually did in school. But of course, you know, without that schooling, without that base knowledge, then none of it would have made sense. So I was first really unsure as to, okay, I don't know what I'm doing here. This is really weird. But luckily, there were a lot of the other more senior engineers were there to kind of help me through it and guide me as to, okay, you know, these are kind of the decisions that are better decisions when it comes to software engineering. And these ones maybe are not as good of steps.
Okay, well, good. Great answer. Okay, so let's talk about your education. So you went to Biola, and what, you know, have you spent any time thinking about the ways in which your Biola education helped you than maybe more than if you'd gone other routes?
Yeah, I think sometimes I think like what it would have been like to go to a university that's more classically computer science and mm-hmm. with like huge computer science department and things like that. But one benefit for sure going to Biola was that I did get a lot more FaceTime with Dr. Lin and the other computer science professors and just general math and engineering professors that were there at the time. So I think that really helped kind of have me relate to the topics we were learning a little bit more, because I got to discuss it further with the professors rather than just showing up to class, reading a book, doing the projects, and then going home. It was a little more collaborative.
Okay, good. It, you know, boy, that one-on-one time is amazing. My whole time at UC Irvine, in 4 years of undergrad, there was exactly one professor who knew my name.
Wow. You
know, most of our freshman engineering classes, you know, were 600 people, something like that. You're just sort of a lost in an ocean. Well, let's take it from a different angle then. So here you are talking to a bunch of juniors and seniors at Biola. Some of them are physics majors and they'll graduate from Biola. Others are in the 3-2 program where they're finishing the third year at Biola and they're going to go 2 years at either USC or maybe ASU or some other school. What advice do you have for them in terms of for the rest of their educational experience? What would you say to them?
I think one thing would be to treasure the Christian aspects of Biola more, because another reason why I really like or don't regret my decision for choosing Biola was that it really was what I needed personally. When it came to my walk with God, I think, again, I was looking into, you know, other universities like the UCs who had better computer science programs. But I feel like where I was at that point in life, I probably would have strayed from God more than, well, straying from God in any capacity isn't really good, but
yeah.
So I think just having that Christian community around you is something to really cherish, because that's not gonna be around forever, it's really a time to really strengthen that foundation that you have in Christ before you go out into the world, and you don't have the people around you aren't all Christian, and most of them aren't going to be, and So yeah, just really solidifying your faith in Christ, I think, is I think the biggest takeaway for me would be.
Okay, great. Hey, let me build on that question. So, you know, from my perspective, what I often see, and I think you and I have talked about this, you know, you'll see kids who grew up in a Christian home and they went to either private elementary school or homeschooled, and then private junior high or homeschooled, private Christian high school or homeschool. And then they go off to Biola. So they're in the bubble, just in the bubble. Right. They graduate, go to work, and then implode. You haven't imploded. So and several of the kids, several of the men and women, sorry, in the class, have a very similar story. Bubble their whole life. When they go to work for the first time, that's going to be the first time they're out of the bubble. And for some of them going on to USC or ASU, that may be the first time out of the bubble. Mm-hmm. You've handled the transition outside to outside the bubble very well. What would you say to people who are about to make that transition? What wisdom can you give them to transition well?
Yeah, that's a really good question. I think for me, something that was really important was that I was I had to make sure that everything I was doing was a personal decision, if that makes sense. Like, I know my parents kind of, you know, they wanted me to go to Biola because I have older siblings who went there as well. But they were also supporting my decision to go to the other universities. But I knew, again, because of where I was personally in my life at the time, that actually going to Biola is what I needed to kind of gain that solidify that core belief within myself, that I wasn't just doing it out of, you know, because my parents wanted me to go there, or, you know, I'm going to church because, you know, this is the right thing to do or something like that. It had to be a very personal reason that I want to go to church or go to a Christian university or do these things because I wanted to strengthen my relationship with Christ. And I think that makes a really big difference, where if you're just kind of acting to satisfy your parents or satisfy the Christian friends around you or things like that, that doesn't really go anywhere. And later in life, you'll find yourself either just doing things, you know, superficially, or you not participating in any of these things at all. So when I choose what church I go to and which friends I hang out with and things like that, it has to be a very intentional decision that, okay, this is what I need to strengthen my relationship with Christ, if that all made sense.
That does. That's a great answer. Well, hey, let me shift gears a little bit. Now, another thing you've done very well at Tandem is you've excelled at having strong relationships with your coworkers. By the way, we did one of these videos also with Austin this just a couple hours ago. And Austin and Jason, I think you guys used to actually sit elbow to elbow, right? You guys were actually next to each other, right? Or were you one over? Well, you're certainly sit very close.
Yeah, we were sat very close, but not right next to each other.
You were within 8 feet of each other, since Austin's been here. But like Austin, you've done very well at relating to other engineers. And, I look back at when I was in high school, and I remember telling a guidance counselor, I want to go into engineering so I don't have to deal with people. And of course, not only do I have to deal with people, I have to work with the worst kind of people, you know, engineers who don't want to work with people, not engineers like Jason. But for me, there was this real transition of it took me maybe a decade to finally come to cherish working with people, but you came right out of the chute good at that. What tips do you have for the listeners in terms of going into a new environment, an engineering environment, particularly where you're surrounded by people with more experience, and you know the talent level is very high at Tandem, so it's a little intimidating. You come there and you're like, whoa. What do you recommend?
I definitely think a huge aspect of it is respect. When it comes to engineering and collaborating on a project, you're not always going to see eye to eye with people. Mm-hmm. You're going to have different opinions on different solutions for the problems that you guys are trying to solve. But I think as long as there's a respect there, a mutual respect, then I think that's actually going to help all that argumentation or whatever butting heads will actually help to create a better product. Right, because if like I don't think necessarily you have to be friends with everyone. Not everyone's gonna like you, but you have to respect them, and there has to be I guess also like some core of like Jesus's love has to be there, even if they don't really like you back.
Okay, I hear you. All right. Well, great answer. And so as we wrap up our time together, is there anything else you'd like to say to these juniors and seniors at Biola University who are all going to be either they're headed toward engineering or physics?
Just anything else to add?
Yeah.
I don't know. I think one thing that actually stood out to me that Tom said to me years ago when I first started Tandem is the habits that I start developing then are the ones that are going to persist throughout the rest of my life. So it's kind of easy to get really busy with the schoolwork or the working, and maybe drop going to church, drop going to Bible study, drop going to small group, or drop reading the Word of God. And maybe not all of those things are 100% necessary to, keep you on the right path with God. But I think it's really important to figure out what helps you the most with your walk with God and make sure to keep with those things as you enter, your professional lives.
Okay, good tip. All right. Well, Jason, thank you so much. Time on behalf of the students, thank you. I know several of them asked me, hey, can you interview some people and tell us a little bit about, what it's like and all that. So thanks for your time, and we'll talk to you later.
All right. See you.